When you were starting out, that game design wasn't really a clear-cut career path. It is now for a lot of people. But who were the people that influenced you as far as wanting to be a game designer? I mean, Gary Gygax, I assume, has some contribution to that. You know, you mentioned Dungeons & Dragons. Were there other game designers or people who wrote about games that kind of shaped how you approached it?
Games were in kind of a really kind of interesting state in the 70s and 80s. There were still a lot of games that I played which were just uncredited, either because they were traditional or because they were published by, Milton Bradley, who didn't put the credit there because they wanted the game to reflect the company, not the designer. Sid Saxon, I was just like I was omnivorous with games, I was also omnivorous with game writing. And that included not only reading about the history of games, Bell wrote a really good book on that, and strategy of games, so I got, read books on bridge strategy, and Go strategy, and chess strategy, and I was just sort of fascinated by all of it, the thinking that went around it. And as far as games and game design, Sid Saxon was one of the best. He, I think he's really one of the pivotal people in the Eurogame world, despite not being Euro. When you